Norman Simmons and others had described in infected plants, sometimes saw ring-like objects. You couldn't see the exact structure of this. But if you took a leaf of an infected plant and simply put it into a negative stain, you could see these ring-like structures. And although I don't think you could see that there were 17 units in this ring, which you could deduce from the X-ray work, it was clearly something very similar. Now, people dismissed this or said that this is an example of a sticky protein, this could be. But Don Caspar, who had held the view that there might be intermediates in the assembly, I took it seriously. And I thought that maybe it's relevant. It is relevant that Don Caspar was right. It's relevant to the assembly. And then I remembered the model of tobacco mosaic virus we built in 1958 for the World's Fair. Well, Ken, the two of you were involved in that. And if you remember, what we did was to get some units made of polystyrene. Rosalind Franklin had been invited to exhibit in the World's Fair. And we exhibited a model of tobacco mosaic virus and a model of a spherical virus. Which would have icosahedral symmetry. So we made things out of polystyrene. I got a sculptor friend of mine, an impoverished sculptor friend, to make these things out of polystyrene and get the right shapes. And in the case of tobacco mosaic virus, we made the shapes. And if you remember, the shapes didn't quite fit. So when they were being assembled into a helical structure, it built out like a flower instead of building up a rod. Yeah. And then I think we sat up all night before it was assembled in Brussels, filing away the surfaces so they would all fit perfectly. It was a great rush job. But the point about that, in order to get this started, I realized it was very hard because you have this, the idea was, this is tobacco mosaic virus, this was before the discovery of the disc. We had to start the assembly. So I got Ernest, as his name was, to build a little helical ramp in which we could put the subunits into a turn of a helix to start off the assembly. And then the TMV RNA was in the form of a plastic pipe, a red plastic pipe. The model is still on the stairs in the lab. And we built almost a complete turn to start off. And then we could start adding the units in to assemble it. So we built a nucleation site, a little scaffold to start the assembly. And then somehow or other the penny dropped, and I don't know at which point it happened, but you remember I referred to the phase change in steel, as I'd done my PhD on nucleation and growth.
Yes.
And I suddenly realized that in order to get such a complicated object built, you needed to nucleate it. And maybe this two-layer disc was the equivalent of this, which you would start putting the RNA down onto the surface of this two-dimensional disc. So it wasn't just an adventitious object, which happened to probably a sticky probe, but maybe it had a biological role,
yeah.
And there were lots of them. Now, I didn't at the time think that we were going to get involved in physical chemistry. But I did go to speak to a meeting at which Don Caspar was there, Robley Williams, a lot of the TMV people, Norman Simmons, and I proposed that this disc would act as a nucleation for the growth of the virus. I remember saying it. It was poo-hooed, but nobody took it up. And then I began to wonder whether, under what circumstance the disc existed, because Reuben had crystallized it under high salt conditions. So I decided, and this was done with Tony Durham, was it?
Yes.
And we'd had a new research student join the lab. Who did the phase diagram?
It was Tony Durham.
Tony Durham.
Yes.
And so I got him to study, because he was a research student and he was very keen and he was a good record. And I said, we ought to find the states of aggregation of TMV protein. See, Don Caspar, who proposed this, never got round ever, it was very characteristic, never got round to actually to studying these things. He would, he, he had a knack of avoiding the not the difficult problems, but the main line problem.